We are previewing week 13 in the NFL here at SBR Forum Videos. I'm Peter Loschak, and we are talking right now with returning guest Stephen O from AccuScore.com. Stephen O, thanks for being with us once again.
Glad to be here.
Stephen O, man. Dude, before we talk about this game, Houston, Tennessee, got to give us another winner last week. Got a little bit lucky, but there's something magical going on with you, man. And like, I feel like I want to make like a little clip of myself kowtowing to all the cappers who, you know, go on these insane winning streaks. What is this, like 6 or 7 in a row? Tell us a little bit about it while I kowtow to you, okay?
Well, I mean, it's pure, let's face it, last week was completely lucky, 4th and 29. Now, I actually wasn't shocked that the Ravens converted a first down, because I thought San Diego, you know, they're the team that will do a stupid roughing the passer, that kind of thing, you know. And I thought there would be a chance that we get, you know, a late hit or something like that. But I didn't think Ray Rice would actually just run the ball for 29 yards.
I hear you. Well, I was just kowtowing to you through all of that. It's been an amazing run. You've got like the magic touch now. You're one of these people who like either wins by a mile, or then even when you're like, you know, losing, you still somehow come out and you know, find a way to win.
Definitely has been a great streak. I do know that, you know, I don't have any of the numbers as far as where the public action is, but it does seem that anytime I pick a game and then, you know, the morning of our calls, I check the numbers in our live odds product, and I see what they are. And they are usually the games that are overwhelmingly one-sided in terms of, you know, where the public is. The game that I like to pick ends up being the same game. So well, I guess it's just a bunch of, you know, like-minded people.
Very impressive, Stephen O. And before we get to the game, I just want to remind viewers that there is the SBR discount code. What does that tell us about that?
Capital S, capital B, capital R is all you have to enter on our join page at AccuScore.com. You get 25% off any of our packages.
Not bad. All right. Let's talk about this week's game, Stephen O, that you chose. Houston at Tennessee. I will tell you that a bunch of other cappers also wanted this game after you selected it. I'm glad that you got it. Let's see what you have to say. Tennessee's a 5.5-point home underdog. And, of course, they're kind of in turmoil. They're, like, eliminated from the playoffs now. They just fired their offensive coordinator. Houston is just absolutely rolling. They are off of two consecutive overtime games, but they do have extra rest, so maybe that doesn't make that much of a difference here. This line looks a little bit tough to me, but I trust you implicitly at this point. What do you like?
Yeah, we like Houston to cover. We have them at an 8 in our simulations, and with a 58% chance of covering 5.5. So far this year, we've been great on both these teams, actually. We're 6-3 on our point spread picks in Houston games and 9-2 in Tennessee games. So, you know, a couple things that we like, obviously, is, you know, Jake Locker, I think, has had 5 starts this year, or 5 games where he played significant amounts. He got injured early in one game. And in the games against top-rated defenses rated in the top half of the league, at least, Tennessee scores around 20. So we think that they're ripe for around a 17-20-point performance this week. And Houston is a team that averages 30 against good and bad teams, and Tennessee's 31st in points allowed. So, you know, it's pretty clear that we have Houston for, you know, at least 26, 27 points or more. So, you know, the basic numbers, I love Houston by at least 8. And, you know, I also like that Houston got that scare at home by Jacksonville a few weeks ago. Mm-hmm. It kind of, and the fact that the Ravens and the Patriots keep winning. So Houston knows that, you know, hey, they can be beat at any time. So they can't let the foot off the gas, and they got to stay ahead of the Ravens, at least for the number one seed.
All right. Well, I'm not doubting you at all. I'm just playing devil's advocate for a second. What about the fact that, you know, the Titans did fire their offensive coordinator, so maybe they'll get a little bit of a rejuvenated offense because of that. And they do have, you know, a lot of offensive weapons. It would never be a surprise if Chris Johnson rushes for 200 yards in a game and, you know, 2 touchdowns or whatever. And, you know, 5.5 points in the NFL is a lot of points. So all those things combined doesn't make you a little bit nervous?
Not really, because, I mean, I don't think the offensive coordinator was tripping guys on the sideline or, right, you know, plays that cost them the job. It's like the Eagles fire their defensive coordinator and they give up 30-something points every week. So I don't think it's always the coordinator's fault. And, you know, I think that in my, you know, our computer says 8. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if it's 38-20 this week. Right. Tennessee's, Houston scored 38 in their matchup against Tennessee in like week 3 or 4. So I kind of see that happening again.
Well, we'll see what happens. We'll see if you can do it again. Thanks so much, Stephen O from AccuScore.com. We'll talk to you again next week.